thank you. I feel very humbled to be with such an esteemed lineup of speakers this evening. So let me start and get right into the thick of it. From the institution's perspective, you know, we would like to have seen things turn out a lot differently over many years coming to this point of having this discussion. The South Africa is facing many infrastructure gaps, both in terms of quantity of infrastructure required as well as the quality of infrastructure that is coming online. And we have come to learn a new word over this time called capture. We understood capture as a very different term, and it sort of redefined its word. You know, the definition has changed over time, and we use it a lot lately, especially when we talk about public infrastructure. So it sort of alludes to one behaving unethically out of choice. Public infrastructure, as we understand it, and when I say we, I say as an industry that looks after the needs of society, providing infrastructure for society at large. So when we look at public infrastructure, in our opinion, as an industry of engineers, it's for a common good. Positive direct and indirect benefits come to society when we deliver good quality infrastructure in very good time. And the economy and society benefits as a whole. It has the potential to boost economic performance, increase productivity, generate aggregate demand by improving human capital and encouraging technological innovation. I'm merely making these statements to set the tone and the context for us and the speakers to start applying their minds in terms of responding to these statements. So some of these benefits are societal objectives, which include inclusive economic participation, inequality, which really relates to SDG goal number 10, the climate issues. Are we behaving ethically when we design our infrastructure in the way we look at the climate in the mix of things? That talks to SDG number 13. Then there's the topic of innovation and infrastructure and industrialization. Are we really ethically planning for that, or is it just talk? And that relates to SDG goal number 9. So if we behave unethically, or if we are in each of our places not exercising what we actually say and we sort of differ from what we actually do, do we really have a chance of attaining this goal of social justice, quality education, decent work and economic growth? I mean, do we really have a chance? And that's the question that I would want to pose to the speakers. So our current attitudes to ethics will certainly ensure that we will not achieve any goals that we set. And what a catastrophe that is looking to be. So I'll leave it there.